ασφάλιν, βαδάιν ποκούν, νοθερά καστάν, αρφινόρο αλτράν, τόνος χόντσιν ροξάν, το βαθήν βαδίν, το
Maurice believes no one should change anything on Nern with magic. Bad things might happen. She keeps her gold clothes.
You've been a good friend to me. That means something.
The throne suits me, don't you think?
Vald, why would you want to help that idiot?
He owes me a steep debt. In fact, he's lucky all I did was force him to work for Mercer. A few years back, I commissioned a unique quill from a good friend of mine in Winterhold. Vald was tasked with getting it here safely, and it ended up at the bottom of Lake Honrik. The wizards called it the Quill of Gemination, and demanded a tremendous amount of gold to have it made. If you can locate the quill and return it to me, something Vald was too stupid to do himself, I'll consider the debt satisfied. The quill was supposed to allow me to duplicate any writing I'm viewing in exacting detail. I'm sure you can understand how useful that would prove in a business situation, especially where signatures were involved. Fortunately, the quill required an ink with a unique formula known only to myself. So if you're getting any ideas about selling it to someone else or keeping it, you'll find it would hold little value. I had Vald meet the caravan from Winterhold on the western end of the lake so he could avoid the roads. The idiot got lost in the mist and ran his boat right over some rocks, sending it straight to the bottom. He's too stupid to remember where he was, and any attempt I've made to find it in the past has been unsuccessful. Vald said his rowboat struck some rocks. I'd check under the water near one of the small islands in the lake. Perhaps you should start at the docks and work your way out towards Golden Glow Estate. I had Vald meet the caravan from Winterhold on the western end of the lake, so he could avoid the roads.
Looking to stay alive?
Buying
Why
and
take
selling
a chance?
Fine jewelry here.
Vegetables as crisp as a winter's morning.
I could have left it behind. I could have put it back where it came from. It is dark. I won't go back. I won't.
There are people who pose as priests, talk about healing and everything. Only talks. And you really do it.
Working the soil with your hands, seeing the seeds take root and grow, tending a herd. There is a joy in this world.
Thank you.
you hold your breath on the water for so long? Sometimes she wonders if you're half fish.
The throne suits me, don't you think? My title is just a formality. I've always been in charge around here. Really, I wrote that off a long time ago. Well, I suppose I need to fulfill my end of the bargain. Give this document to Vald. It frees him from the debt, but I never want to see him in Riften again.
Say the college has been snooping around Sorthal. The mage is in a burial crypt. No good can come of that.
Protect yourself right. Buy armor from Grelka.
I should have come here.
No one could offer a just horror!
Huh?
Keep quiet.
So much water here. Don't splash her. Stop shoving, would you? Watch it! here. Lots of fishes, and it's not so cold.
Or something?
Time to end this wicked game.
done for body and evil. I suppose someone has already been sacrificed.
We've scoured the town and I've spoken to every contact we have left. No sign of Mercer. Any luck on your end? Shor's beard. He's going after the eyes of the Falmer? That was Gallus's pet project. If he gets his hands on them, you can be certain he'll be gone for good and set up for life. Agreed. He's taken everything the Guild has left, and to go after one of the last greatest heists is just an insult. I've spoken to Carlaya and made amends for how the Guild's treated her. Now she wishes to speak with both of us. Quickly, we have no time to lose. Until next we meet, Lass.
Yeah, you need something?
Still here. Renew. The time has come to decide Mercer's fate. Until a new guildmaster is chosen, the decision falls to you.
Aye, lass. And I've come to a decision.
Mercer Frey tried to kill both of you. He betrayed the guild, murdered Gallus, and made us question our future. He needs to die.
We have to be very careful, Brynjolf. Mercer is a nightingale, an agent of Nocturnal.
And it's all true. Everything I heard in the stories. The Nightingales, their allegiance to Nocturnal and the Twilight Sepulchre.
Yes. That's why we need to prepare ourselves and meet Mercer on equal footing. Just outside of Riften, beyond the southeast gate, is a small path cut up the mountainside. At the end of that path is a clearing, and an old standing stone.
You were abandoned, huh?
I'd ask you both to meet me.
Yeah. Here. What of it? So, is it true bandits get, you know...
I'm preparing to leave for the standing stone. What is it?
You're an idiot.
Oh!
Shoving, would you? Thank you.
you're here. This is the headquarters of the Nightingales, cut into the mountainside by the first of our kind. We've come to seek the edge we need to defeat Mercer Frey. If you'll follow me, I'll try to explain on the way. Gallus, Mercer Frey and I were once members of what's known as the Nightingale Trinity. The Trinity disbanded 25 years ago when Mercer Frey betrayed us by slaying Gallus and dumping his body in the ruins of Snowvale Sector. Indirectly, the Trinity is usually selected from the ranks of the Guild, although its existence is a closely guarded secret. The Nightingales protect the Temple of Nocturnal, a place known as the Twilight Sepulchre. She's the mistress of night and darkness, and the patron of every thief in Tamriel. Nocturnal isn't one for worship and reverence. There are no priests and no sermons, no services and no arms. She influences our luck, and in return, demands payment. You're closer to understanding than you realize. The only difference is she doesn't demand payment in the traditional sense, and sometimes the cost can be quite high. Whether you know it or not, Nocturnal dictates how well we perform as rogues. Again, you have to think differently. Haven't you ever noticed how our luck behaves? Like a novice picking an impossible lock, or a blind man suddenly turning to face you as you reach for his pocket. It's through these subtle means that Nocturnal influences us. Nocturnal's whim is the greatest mystery to everyone. There have been volumes written on the subject. Does she exact payment when we die? When we suffer? Does she revel in our misery? No one knows. The return certainly seems worth the risk, though. From the moment you were struck with my poisoned arrow at Snowvale Sanctum, my path changed its course. Perhaps I couldn't bring Mercer back alive, but together, we were able to clear my name and to put Gallus's memory to rest. I'd always intended Mercer's fate to ultimately be decided by the Guild. Seems they've spoken. It's my hope that you will, yes. This will. The assumption that the Nightingales were just a myth was seeded within the Guild on purpose. It helped divert attention from our true nature. What's wrong, Brynjolf? I can almost hear your brow furrowing.
I'm trying to understand why I'm here, lass. I'm no priest, and I'm certainly not religious. Why pick me?
This isn't about religion, Brynjolf. It's business. This is Nightingale Hall. You're the first of your uninitiated to set foot inside in over a century. Now, if you'll both proceed to the armory to don your Nightingale armor, we can begin the oath.
I think we should trust the lass and take the deal.
You are here ready for the oath.
Okay, lass. We've got these get-ups on. Now what?
Beyond this gate is the first step in becoming a nightingale.
Whoa there, lass. I appreciate the armor, but becoming a nightingale? That was never discussed.
She hopes you won't start marking your
territory. We must have Nocturnal at our backs.
You know,
if she's to accept you as one of her own, an arrangement must be struck.
What sort of arrangement? I need to know the terms.
The terms are quite simple, Brynjolf. Nocturnal will allow you to become a nightingale and use your abilities for whatever you wish. And in return, both in life and in death, you must serve as a guardian of the Twilight Sepulchre.
Aye, there's always a catch. But at this point, I suppose there isn't much to lose. If it means the end of Mercer Frey, you can count me in.
What about you? Are you ready to transact the oath with Nocturnal? Good. After I open the gate, please stand on the Western Circle. We'll speak when the oath is complete.
Time's waiting.
We'll speak when the oath is complete.
Carlia, I was wondering when I'd hear from you again. Lose something, did we?
My lady, I've come before you to throw myself upon your mercy and to accept responsibility for my failure.
You're already mine, Carlia. Your terms were struck long ago. What could you possibly offer me now?
I have two others that wish to transact the oath. To serve you both in life and in death.
You surprise me, Carlyle. This offer is definitely weighted in my favor.
My appetite for Mercer's demise exceeds my craving for wealth and grace.
Revenge. How interesting. Very well. The conditions are acceptable. You may proceed.
Lady Nocturnal. We accept your terms. We dedicate ourselves to you as both your avengers and your sentinels. We will honor our agreement in this life and the next until your conditions have been met.
Very well. I name your initiates Nightingale, and I restore your status to the same, Carlyle. And in the future, I'd suggest you refrain from disappointing me again.
Transacted the oath. It's time to reveal the final piece of the puzzle to you. Mercer's true crime. Mercer was able to unlock the Guild's vault without two keys because of what he stole from the Twilight Sepulchre, the skeleton key. By doing this, he's compromised our ties to Nocturnal, and in essence, caused our luck to run dry. Well, yes, but the key isn't only restricted to physical barriers. All of us possess untapped abilities, the potential to wield great power securely sealed within our minds. Once you realize the key can access these traits, potential becomes limitless. Good. Then you understand why this is about more than just Mercer's lust for power. If the key isn't returned to its lock in the Twilight Sepulchre, things will never be the same for the Guild. As time passed, our luck would diminish to the point of non-existence. And whether you know it or not, our uncanny luck defines our trade. Very true. In our line of work, it's quite rare we set out to return a stolen item to its rightful owner. Before we depart, Brynjolf has some business to discuss. I suggest you listen to him.
Listen, lass. There's one last piece of business we need to settle before we go after Mercer. The leadership of the Guild. Carlyle and I had a long discussion before you arrived here. Thanks to your efforts, Mercer's treachery has been exposed. After we deal with him, all that remains is restoring the Guild to its full strength. As a result, we both feel that you have the potential of replacing Mercer as leader of the Thieves' Guild.
I've been at this game a long time, my friend. A long time. I've stolen trinkets from nobles and framed priests for murder. I'm good at what I do, maybe even one of the best, but it's all I know. I've never been one to lead. Never desired it, never cared for it. Don't want it. Well, we have a bit of an errand to run before your coronation, so don't get sentimental on me now. Then it's decided. When this is all over and Delvin's contacts assure me that we've regained our footing in Skyrim, we'll handle the details. Until then, we have quite the task ahead. I've been poring over the plans you brought us, and I'm convinced the eyes of the Falmer are in the Dwarven ruins at Erkenthat. Carlyle and I will meet you there. Prepare yourself, lass. This will be a fight to remember. If you would have asked me that yesterday, I'd have said no. But now I think our chances have improved. Look, call me crazy if you like, but I trust Carlyle. I don't think she'd lead us down a suicidal path. Besides, I'd rather die with some of Mercer's blood on my blade than spend the rest of my life regretting that I ran the other way. Aye. And some of what Carlyle said is starting to make sense. Mercer may have damaged our reputation and raided our coffers, but this goes well beyond even his twisted form of larceny. Old Delvin kept calling it a curse, and we all laughed at him. Looks like the joke's on us.
Still here? Right behind you.
Thank you.
craftsmanship.
Need some gold. I may have some work for you. Got lots of jobs available. Interested? I handle. If breaking's a more your thing, go talk to Vex. All right. Anything in particular strike your fancy? Most of the establishments in Skyrim keep their transactions recorded within business ledgers. Your job will be to change the numbers in those books. So the shortfalls from our other jobs look legit. Feel like doing a bit of writing? Just remember the rules. Keep it clean and keep it quiet. Here's the details. Pull up a seat. Ah, you're back. Well, well. I was looking for this little beauty. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. Must have come from Mercer's place. He'd admired the Grey Fox for some time. Sure, I'll buy it from you. Here you are. Don't forget you're representing the Guild. Don't do anything stupid.
Ready for some work, or are you just gonna wander around all day? I handle the burglary, shell, sweep, and heist jobs. Most of them involve breaking and entering. If you don't like that kind of work, talk to Delvin. He runs the more up-close and personal jobs. Good. We could use the coin. Pretty simple. Break into a house, grab a specific item, and get out before they realize what's going on. The catch is you can't kill anyone who lives there, or you forfeit the payment. You ready for some good old-fashioned burglary? Whatever. Just get it done. Here's the job.
Discredits mages. They are... odd. What? Yes, you're odd too. Then.
Huh? I'm sorry.
Need a ride?
Don't do that!
I can take you to any... Where do you want to go?
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
You'd best hurry it up.
Solitude's a big port town, you know, full of sailors and their tales of faraway lands. Most of...
I'm not gonna warn you again. Get out or I'll call the guards. You should have listened. Guards, help! Trespasser!
You better run!
You know you can afford a septim or two.
You should see me get bored, stranger. I'm staying out of this. I've got a little work if you're interested.
A coin or two for a veteran? It's not much to ask.
Fresh fish! Straight from the fjords.
not gonna warn you again. Get out or I'll call the guards. Hey, that isn't yours. You should have listened. Guards, help!
Stop
shouting the orders of y'all. Stop right there.
Watch it! Lives lost, crops burned, land ruined. There's no greater sin than war.
Can I help you?
All right, then.
Hopes you won't start marking your, territory. You know, as, God.
Need a ride? Where do you want to go? Climb and back, and we'll be off. I can't wait here forever. Get up there. I can take you to any of the...
We Khajiits have fur. Does it mean there's colder in elsewhere? Even colder than here?
What can I do for you, friend?
Dixie heard that loud in the tavern say it was a full shipment of furs.
You idiot. He said furs, not furs. It was a damn logging caravan.
So, what can I do for you to... This kind of work suits you? And it's going to end up making you rich. Great. What'd you want to do? Anything in particular strike your fancy? These marks keep their ledges all neat and tidy, but they're right for some change, if you know what I mean. take it? Just keep your eyes open and your mouth shut and you'll do fine. Let me give you the details.
Done or what? Amazing what people leave laying around for us to take, isn't it? Okay, what'll it be? Got more than you can handle. Sure, sure. We're always looking to get our hands on items from all over Skyrim. How about this one? All right, take this and get out of here.
So this city is the home of the thieves. Wait,